Roller derby fans around the world, good morning. I'm Biff Mix-a-Lot. I am joined by Sissy Splasek. Our producer this morning will be October Revolution. And you're watching the 2019 International WFTDA Playoffs here in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. Brought to you by Greensboro Roller Derby and the Women's Flat Track Derby Association. This morning, first bout of day number three. Don't be sad it's ending. Be happy that it's happening. Our first game features Atlanta Roller Derby, ranked number 21 in the world, the number 9 seed entering the tournament, taking on Helsinki Roller Derby, the 6th seed, ranked number 16 in the WFTDA. This is the first ever meeting between these two teams.
Yeah, it's going to be such an exciting game. Let's see that roster for Atlanta. We have 101, Rosie Deriviter, 1017, Gucci Mame, 1059, Get Off My Lawn, number 12, Rebel Yellow, number 128, Coco, number 143, Baller Shot Collar, 1915 is Ziploc, 21 is Blackjack, 213 is Aphrodite, number 23 is Matitude Adjustment, number 31 is Erica Baduzzi, number 33 Troublemaker, number 394 Hermione Danger, number 5 Air Throttle, and number 76 Queen Lugitifa.
And skating this morning for Helsinki, it's number 112 Fuchs, number 156 Mia, number 22 Malu, number 24 Kuyala, number 28 Nina Uris, number 39 Mayurine, number 42, Nuki. Number 51, Alu. Number 604, Sarah Ekholm. Number 613, Yamina Lugora. Number 77, Rotsalainen. Number 85, Latakainen. Number 88, Varbu Knutila. And number 90, Sala Karjalainen. And we got here, Helsinki prevailed in their first game, 217-66 against Lum. They lost a rather tense bout to Rainey yesterday, 126-145. And Atlanta, they got here as they started as the number 9 seed. They defeated Bay Area 188-89 and lost a really hard-fought physical game yesterday to Texas.
Yeah, that game was very intense. Atlanta and Texas, no strangers to playing each other. It's happened, well, since Derby's been around. They're both founding members. Yeah, very hard-fought bout. Lost to Texas. Had an amazing first half. And then in the second half, was holding strong. And then you could start to see some of that speed and just starting to get a little bit of tired, a little bit of fatigue, but they are in really good spirits, talked to them this morning, and really excited for this game. They wanted to play Helsinki and
okay.
Wanted to see how it's going.
Well, should be an exciting matchup. They're pretty close in the rankings. Helsinki, this, you know, they came to Classic Georgia Tabiatush in Montreal in June. They played, you know, four of the top 20 teams in the WFTDA, so I think they're ready for their run through the playoffs here. So we are less than a minute away from starting. They had a very close game with Rainey yesterday. First, the jammer line for Helsinki will be number 156, Mia, and jamming for Atlanta, number 213, Aphrodite. Our officials, our skating officials, Dred Hockley, Colin M. Fairley, Technical Difficulty, Oliver Pist, Tim the Ref, Queen Kictoria, Chad Holderfield, and Gym Class Hero.
And of course, as always, we'd love to hear from you, so hit up that Twitter, hashtag #talk2, WFTDA. We'd love to see what you're saying and follow along with us.
All right. We're here for your questions.
And your compliments.
We always like those, yeah. Also, check out the handle at WFTDA Live. And we are 5 seconds away from the start. We'll go over our non-skating officials when we get an opportunity. And game number one of day number three is underway. Aphrodite with the most forward progress. Both jammers still stuck in the pack. Packs break apart. Aphrodite recycled to the rear of the pack. Neither jammer able to find a path. There goes Aphrodite, lead jammer for Atlanta.
Both teams playing really similar defense so far in this first pass. We're seeing those tripods, and we're seeing the tripod with an eye towards offense for the other side, and literally spread inside and outside of the tracks. So we'll see how that continues.
They're covering every inch of the track. Aphrodite was out, but Mia Follett was very quickly out of the pack behind her, forcing a quick call off the jam. That jam was scoreless. Our score holds at 0-0.
You saw that quick replay there of Aphrodite just dropping that shoulder and edging to the inside to get that lead.
Okay, jamming for Helsinki is number 42, Nuki. Jamming against number 33, that is Troublemaker of Atlanta. And Troublemaker at the front of the pack. One blocker to beat. She picks up a forearm penalty. That's going to put, that is a track cut. So Helsinki with the first power jam opportunity of the bout. Nuki, one blocker to beat at the front. She spins out and is lead. Pack is reassembling in turns one and two. Queen Luziatifa dealing out a big block on the Helsinki pivot. That is number 85, Latakainen. Nuki on a scoring pass, is through, picks up four, calls the jam. 4-0 in favor of Helsinki, and they freeze Atlanta's jammer in the penalty box, which will give the benefit of a power jam start to number 88, Varpu Knutila.
This jam brought to you by Quick in the Rydell family. When you need to roll quick, think quick. Quick bearings where precision meets performance.
So the pack starts roughly in between the jammer and pivot lines. Knutila, the only jammer on the track. Jam is underway. Jam number three. Knutila around the outside. Face-to-face with two Atlanta blockers. And Knutila spins out, gains lead. Penalty to Troublemaker has expired. So Atlanta able to defend what was left of that power jam. Knutila enters on a scoring pass.
Looks like she ran right into the inside of Erica Baduzzi there, and Queen Luziatifa will be our first blocker penalty for Atlanta with a forearms.
Atlanta, Troublemaker, handing off the jammer's star to
Blackjack.
Blackjack, yeah. Thank you.
Yeah, you're going to see Blackjack. She jammed a lot for Atlanta last year at playoff season. Hasn't really jammed at all this year during the season, but will be wearing that pivot and will be taking a lot of passes.
All righty then. So Aphrodite returning to the jammer line for Atlanta against number 22, Malu of Helsinki. Helsinki's blockers drifting forward.
And we're seeing that pivot line start.
Yes. It's been a while since we've seen one of those.
Yeah, there's been a handful over the weekend, but pretty early in the game for that.
Malu finds a path to the outside. She is lead for Helsinki. Aphrodite out of the pack in hot pursuit. The pack organizing between turns one and two. Malu on a scoring pass through the pack, calls the jam. That's four more for Helsinki.
Looks like Latakainen really did a great job on coming back into that Atlanta wall, setting herself into the outside and being right there to hold. You'll see them right there with that shirt whip.
Well done there by Helsinki. So Helsinki extends their lead 12-0, 25-42 left in the period. Kujala, the jammer now for Helsinki against number 1017. I believe that's Gucci Mame. Her first time with the jammer star for Atlanta. Jam is underway.
Yes, I erroneously said the first day that Gucci was a transfer from Jax. She is a transfer from Tallahassee. But she told me that it's okay to say she's from Niceville.
Okay. There's a lot of nice parts of Florida.
There's some great parts. Yeah. It's lovely.
So Gucci Mame, having made the most forward progress, she's met with a tripod of Helsinki blockers that she's held up long enough to allow Kujala to be lead jammer once for Helsinki. Took about 40 seconds to establish lead on that. Gucci Mame out of the pack. Penalty to number 51, Alu. Jam is called. One additional point for Helsinki. No points for Atlanta.
Atlanta scoreless so far. We are at Helsinki 13, Atlanta with 0. 24 minutes in this first period.
Atlanta showing off a pretty broad jammer rotation. Number 394, Hermione Danger, now jamming for Atlanta against Mia of Helsinki. Jam is underway. Each team with one blocker in the penalty box to start. Mia has recycled into turn four. Mia on her toe stops around the outside is lead for Helsinki.
And Helsinki with almost all of the lead jammer calls so far this game. Aphrodite had one, but all of the rest so far have gone to Helsinki.
So Hermione Danger out of the pack, in pursuit. Jam is called. Three more points for Helsinki. That'll push their score out to 16-0 for Atlanta. We have 23 minutes, 30 seconds left in the period.
We're seeing that replay there. Baller shot caller pushed to the outside line, tries to get a handle on Mia and is just not able to.
Back to the jammer line for Helsinki is number 42, Nuki. Shield jam against number 213, Aphrodite of Atlanta. Aphrodite rolling towards the jammer line as the jam starts. Both jammers locked up in the blocking sled, but Nuki finds a path around the inside and is lead for Helsinki.
Rosie DeRiveter with the pivot star there for Atlanta with a beautiful offensive takeout on the outside to make that hole for Aphrodite.
So Aphrodite approaches with speed as the jam is called. Wasn't able to steal any points for Atlanta. 2 points for Helsinki.
This game brought to you by S1 Helmets, the S1 Lifer Visor Helmet, next level protection. There you're seeing Aphrodite look to the inside. There's that offensive push. Rebel Yellow, Queen Luz Yutifa, making room on that inside and able to cut right through.
So we're back to action. Number 33, Troublemaker, the jammer for Atlanta against number 88, Varpu Knutila. Troublemaker around the inside, lead jammer for Atlanta. Knutila still locked up in the pack. Troublemaker approaching on a scoring pass. Helsinki's blocker stacked at the rear. Ekholm leading the defending the line for Helsinki at the rear. Knutila, go ahead.
Sorry, two penalties called. Very quick succession there. Matitude adjustment, and then that is number 90, Sala for Helsinki.
Troublemaker with the first 4 points of the game for Atlanta. Circulating around on the second scoring pass. Pack stopped in the back straightaway. In front of the fan zone. In front of the unicorn pool floaties.
In front of the wonderful blankets and pillows that have been provided.
So Knutila finishes off a scoring pass for Helsinki. That'll give them four. And Troublemaker collecting a second 4 points. That is eight for Atlanta.
Troublemaker having a great tournament so far. She was out this entire year with an injury. You'll see wearing that boxing glove and giving us a nice little apex jump while doing it.
No impediment to the apex hop there. So that's a third scoring pass for Troublemaker. 12-8 on the jam in favor of Atlanta. Pack scatters into the front straightaway. Troublemaker on a fourth scoring pass. Knutila following her into the pack. And Troublemaker is out. That is 16 points on the jam. Knutila still locked up in the pack. Troublemaker running the jam. This is a fifth scoring pass now for Atlanta. Troublemaker through 20 points on the jam. Biggest jam for either team.
Atlanta definitely taking advantage. Helsinki has had sort of a revolving penalty box this jam so far. This is the first time they've only had one blocker there. They've been up to two and then in and out three. Definitely taking advantage of that.
Jam ends. Three additional points for Helsinki, three more for Atlanta. That was four more. So 24-11 that jam goes in favor of Atlanta. Our score now, 29-24.
Troublemaker there in that replay with that apex jump as Helsinki is diving hips to the line to try to get a piece of her, unable to.
So this is almost a brand new game at this point. Gucci Mame with the jammer star for Atlanta. Forced into the ref lane, has to recycle. Malou is the jammer for Helsinki. Malou stashing the star, gets through first, is not lead. Gucci Mame picks up lead, calls the jam as Malou approaches. So a scoreless jam. Score will remain 29-24. 19-14 left in the first period.
There you're seeing Gucci just as she picks up that lead, hips around number 85 there. Oh, and yes, that big hit.
Just a last second there hit by Fuchs to rein her back into the pack.
Yeah.
So the jammer now for Atlanta is Hermione Danger. She'll be jamming against number 24, Kujala of Helsinki. Hermione Danger drawn back behind the jammer line. And Kujala through first, but oh, she picked up a track cut. And that's going to put Atlanta on the power jam. Hermione Danger battling with the front of the Helsinki pack.
This is Hermione Danger's first time at playoffs.
Yeah, penalty to an Atlanta blocker.
Yeah, it looks like Blackjack making a, or sorry, oops, baller shot caller.
Shot caller.
Baller shot caller
penalty.
Making such a face as she was going.
So Hermione Danger finally, 50 seconds into the jam, gains lead for Atlanta. Kujala's penalty is done. Pack stopped in the back straightaway. Hermione Danger on a scoring pass. Kujala has to recycle. And that is 4 points for Hermione Danger.
Ziplock had a piece of Kujala all the way on the inside, and then you saw that Helsinki tripod just wrap around her to make that space.
Kujala, very tough jammer to contain there for a Helsinki. Kujala on a scoring pass, Hermione Danger on a second scoring pass for Atlanta. Locked up in the pack, held up there by Sala Karjalainen. Pack comes to a grinding halt behind the jammer line. Hermione Danger, almost casually finding a path around the outside. She's knocked up by Alou. Baller shot caller picking up another penalty for Atlanta.
It looks like that was a multiplayer for Baller.
So Helsinki setting up a tripod at the rear. Hermione Danger. Jam time's out. So three additional points for Atlanta, four for Helsinki.
It was a little tricky. All the fingers were together on that one.
So it ends up an 8-4 jam, and we now have a one-point game, 33-32, still in favor of Helsinki.
Magnitude adjustment with that offensive inside sweep to clear the path for Hermione Danger.
Aphrodite back to the jammer line for Atlanta. I got number 42, Nuki. Aphrodite is through. Lead jammer for Atlanta.
Afro so far the lead scorer for Atlanta this tournament. Trouble really giving her a run for her money today, though.
Now Trouble did have the biggest jam of the game so far. But Aphrodite through for 4 points for Atlanta. Nuki still bottled up the rear of the pack. She escapes. Aphrodite in a second scoring pass. Nice little block there from Queen Luz Yatifa.
Yeah, you saw Baller push to the outside. You saw Queen and Blackjack open up to the push to the inside and throw right up the middle.
So Aphrodite, a third scoring pass now. Action comes to a halt there in between turns one and two. Aphrodite on one skate, almost out of the pack. She's held up now by Fuchs.
Fuchs with such beautiful lateral movement, really opening those skates.
Unfortunately for Aphrodite, there was a high block involved there. So this is going to put Helsinki on the power jam.
Not a penalty she usually gets.
And not that tall in stature, so. So Helsinki on the power jam with Nuki as their jammer. And Nuki collects 4 points.
Looks like we had a little bit of a star stash there.
So the pack reorganizes at the exit of turn two. Nuki approaches on a second scoring pass. Whistles in the pack. Queen Luz Yatifa interrupting Nuki's progress there.
Looks like Fuchs heading to the penalty box. I believe that was a high block on Baller Shot Caller.
So the penalty to Aphrodite has expired. Jam ends. Three additional points for Helsinki. And four more for Atlanta. A 12-7 jam. We have a lead change.
And we have an official review for Helsinki. In your replay there, you're seeing Yeah, that push to the outside.
Ekholm coming together there with Zip Block, I believe that was.
This game brought to you by Adam Skates. Have you tried the Adam Savant wheels? See what you've been missing? All the information at adamskates.com. This game has picked up. It feels like
it has.
Maybe started a little bit slow. Okay, we're seeing a replay there. Aphrodite hips around, looks back to make sure.
She didn't have much more than a toe stop's width around the perimeter of the track there. And she took every millimeter of it to get around.
Yeah, you will see Fro do that look back.
Nope.
Helsinki would like to request an insubordination penalty to the Atlanta Gemmer for failing to exit the track.
Okay.
All righty then. So the referees are adjudicating that as we speak. Now, take a second to go over our non-skating officials. Strong female character. I want to give a shout-out to Itty Bitty Gritty Kitty. Stabby McNeedles, Mistress Grimm, Slammerous, Beastnik, Bert Hurt, Sawed-Off, Rabbit Derby Fan, Alex, and Wicked Widget. And without them, it would not be possible. I did that.
Okay. All right, I guess we are seeing a little bit of that precursor there of the high block. See the look back and the skate off. Okay.
Well, we'll see how they judge that.
Yeah. I mean, I know a lot of times a skater is going to look back, one, to make sure it's for them, two, to make sure it wasn't a lead call, you know, or something else. And we will see what they decide in just a minute. Yeah, this game started a little slow. Yeah. It felt like they were trying to feel each other out, knew that both teams were going to be very defensive heavy and also have some zippy jammers. And then the last few jams have really picked up.
Yeah, pace has definitely picked up here.
The officials have concluded that once the Atlanta Jammer acknowledged the penalty, they exited the track. No penalty will be assessed. Helsinki does not retain their review.
Okay.
All righty then. So Helsinki loses that review. Atlanta wins. And we will get returning to the jammer line for Atlanta, number 33, Troublemaker. Jamming against number 156, Mia of Helsinki. Helsinki with a blocker in the penalty box to start. Jam is underway.
And Mia having an outstanding weekend so far.
And Mia, through the pack, gains lead. The pack advances into turn one. Mia approaching on a scoring pass. Atlanta setting up a tripod at the rear. Led by Erythrottle. And Mia escapes. Hops through the inside. Picks up 4 points for Helsinki. So Pack reassembles at the exit of turn two. And Mia quickly through for another 4 points.
Looks like we have had a star pass to the pivot attitude adjustment.
So Helsinki acknowledging that with Salakarja Leinen holding her up at the front of the pack. Mia, meanwhile, threw on a third scoring pass. That's 12 points for Helsinki. Attitude adjustment takes a tumble to the infield and picks up a penalty.
That is definitely an unlucky penalty since she will be serving as the jammer.
Yeah, she had the jammer star in hand as she took the tumble. I did not see what that penalty was.
It looks like it was a pack, so okay. Maybe a destruction.
Pack destruction,
or
out of play penalty. So in the meantime, Helsinki collected 16 points through Mia. They lead now by 56-44.
Baller tried to get a piece on Mia, and Mia with an epically high apex jump all the way over Baller.
Malou taking the jammer star with the power jam now for Helsinki. Big coagulation of blockers at the pivot line. Malou probing for a seam.
Clarification, looks like Mattitude's penalty was a low block.
Okay. A penalty nonetheless. Malou gains lead status. Pack assembles at the exit of turn two at a standstill. Malou Finds a path around the outside. Collects four for Helsinki. Packett set up at the exit of turn two. Malou on a second scoring pass. She comes face to face with Rebel Yellow. Forced out. Drawn back by Queen Luziatifa.
And it feels like it's old school derby for a second. Mattitude not serving a minute penalty. She had actually picked up two penalties. A low block and a forearms.
Wow. That nice little combo platter there. Fortunately, adds up to two penalties for Atlanta. So Malou calls the jam, and that is with Mattitude adjustments standing in the penalty box. Mia will get the benefit of a power jam start now. 63-44. They picked up seven on that last jam.
And it looks like Mattitude joined by Blackjack at the very end of that jam.
So we have a brief official timeout. Back to 5 seconds. Pack retreats to the jammer line. Jam is underway. Mia tries to find a path inside, is unsuccessful. Penalty to Mattitude adjustment has expired.
You see Maddie tried to take advantage of the chaos of the jam start and zip through as quickly as she could, but Helsinki did see that on the inside.
So a good bit of pack awareness there by Helsinki. Mia trying to dig in between Wild Cherry and Zip Block. Is able to find a path through. Lead jammer for Helsinki.
I believe that's air throttle, only because Wild Cherry is on a trip back home already.
Oh, I apologize. I'm so sorry. Air throttle.
But yeah, used to be number five.
Okay. And a penalty assessed to Blackjack. And unfortunately for Atlanta, Blackjack has the jammer star. A forearm penalty assessed to Blackjack. Mia collects 4 points, calls the jam. And Helsinki will once again get to take advantage of a power jam start.
And I was going to say, if I know Atlanta, we're going to see a timeout on this one. And that's exactly what we just saw from Dr. Lady Danger. Reset. Two jammer penalties in a row. Well, pivot to jammer penalties in a row.
Yeah.
And a strong run there from Helsinki.
So Helsinki, 23 unanswered points.
Seeing in the replay there, Mia pivot to the outside, steps out. Zip also stepping out and returning to the back of the pack. Yeah, we're seeing that replay.
Yeah.
It's a difficult angle over here. I know the officials have a much better line directly to it. We got some jammer stats for you. Lead scorer on the Helsinki side with 19 is Mia, followed by
Varpu Knutila with
Knutila.
15. Nuki with 13. Very, very balanced scoring attack for Helsinki so far. Troublemaker with the biggest jam of the game for Atlanta. And speaking of Nuki, she is back to the jammer line with the benefit of a power jam start. Atlanta at least has a full set of blockers to defend this power jam. Jam gets underway. Nuki planted to the infield.
Erica Baduzzi with that inside hit and quick hip flip around.
So Nuki drawn back behind the jammer line. Nuki tangled up among the Atlanta blockers. Atlanta doing a good job locking down on this power jam start. And they hold things up enough for Blackjack to get out of the penalty box.
Yeah, Queen and Coco with that outside lockdown, joined by Erica Baduzzi, and of course, Baller Shot Collar with that pivot.
Blackjack out of the penalty box, lead jammer for Atlanta. Helsinki passing the jammer star. That is 85, Latakainen with the jammer star now for Helsinki. Latakainen completes her initial pass, is through on a scoring pass. And she is sent to the inside by Queen Luziatifa. Blackjack, in the meantime, collects 4 points for Atlanta.
Coco and Erica Baduzzi in the penalty box for Atlanta.
Latakainen approaching the pack as Blackjack collects another four.
And that was our first star pass for Helsinki so far this game.
No, their jammers have had pretty good success navigating the Atlanta pack.
Yeah, it definitely feels like they watched a lot of tape and the game so far this weekend, especially that Texas game.
Yeah. So Blackjack, drawn back behind the pivot line, will re-enter the pack, meeting a tripod of Helsinki blockers. Blackjack getting an assist from Erica Beduzzi.
Yeah, you can see Blackjack waiting on the outside of the track for Erica Beduzzi to be standing in order to make that entrance.
Baller shot caller desperately trying to keep Latikainen in the pack. As the jam is called, three more points for Atlanta. Eight total for Helsinki, so that's an 11-8 jam in favor of Atlanta. Score stands now 75-55.
There's that replay of Blackjack into that three wall, pushing forward, a little help from baller shot caller.
Atlanta skaters really working together well to get to navigate Helsinki's pack play. So the jammer now for Atlanta is number 10-17, Gucci Mame. She's jamming against Malu of Helsinki, and Gucci Mame has lead jammer status in the bag. Malu escapes the pack. Gucci Mame approaching on a scoring pass as the pack organizes in the back straightaway. Gucci Mame is through for 4 points. She'll call the jam.
Ziplock and Rosie DeRiveter just parting the Helsinki waters for Gucci.
Parting the green sea, as it were. Hey, it's Sunday. We got to have a Sunday school lesson in there somewhere.
Seeing Baller with that lateral move on Malu, joined by Ziplock. So low for the catch, and then Gucci taking advantage of it for that inside run.
Well done there by Atlanta. Aphrodite is returning to the jammer line for Atlanta against Kujala. And Kujala to the front of the pack, gets lead.
Kujala is slipping through like butter on that line.
Kujala has been a difficult jammer to contain all weekend for Helsinki.
Kujala watching seems like it's going to be like it's going to be very like forward moving and powering through his shoulders, and then just slips that amazing lateral in there.
Well, in the meantime, Aphrodite picked up a penalty, so Kujala now on the power jam for Helsinki. Kujala's picked up 4 points. She's on a second scoring pass. One blocker to beat at the front. That is a second 4 point scoring pass.
And that was a cut track for Fro.
And Pack gathers in the apex of turns one and two. Penalty to Aphrodite is expired. Kujala around the outside, picking up another 4 points. 12 total in the jam for Helsinki. Aphrodite working on her initial pass. Kujala re-enters the pack. This is a fourth scoring pass for Helsinki. Kujala comes out. Aphrodite pops out right behind her.
Kujala taking advantage. That offensive push came to the outside of Queen Lujatifa, started to push against it, and that tension opened just the tiniest line for Kujala right on the middle.
Kujala didn't need much space there.
No. Not much space at all if you're watching that line there. Pulls Matitude to the inside just enough to cut to the out.
Yeah, Matitude couldn't quite contain her there. So back to the jammer line for Helsinki is number 88, Varpu Knutila, against number 33, Troublemaker of Atlanta. Knutila bottled up at the rear of the pack by Blackjack, among others. And Knutila comes out the other side, lead jammer for Helsinki. Ziplock couldn't quite hold her in the pack, Troublemaker. Almost out of the pack, she dragged a toe stop on the inside line. She'll have to retreat behind number 51, Alou.
And the officials with a better vantage than us. I was like, I don't know how close that toe stop is.
Maybe caution being the better part of valor in that situation to avoid the penalty. Knutila is through with 4 points.
Baller shot caller picking up a forearms penalty.
And Troublemaker with the star stash completes her initial pass. Knutila will call the jam with another 4 points in hand. And that will push Helsinki to the brink of 100 points, 99-59, under 4 minutes remaining.
Derby Without Borders is a charity project dedicated to smashing the barriers of accessibility to roller derby around the world by providing leagues with coaching, support, and equipment. You can find out all you need at derbywithoutborders.org.
So we'll have Mia returning to the chamber line for Helsinki against Hermione Danger. Both teams employing 6 jammers so far in this game.
That's so many jammers.
Well, half the roster almost. In the meantime, Mia picking up lead jammer for Helsinki. Pack is scattered around turns 1 and 2. Mia cruising through, picking up 4 points. Hermione Danger, star in hand. And that star has been handed off to Baller Shot Caller.
Yeah, Baller positioned herself in a great place for it, was slid up to the inside, already was around the blockers, and then reached the hand back to grab.
We've seen that little behind-the-back panty grab or the cover grab there.
Yeah, we were saying it yesterday. It felt a lot like we were watching the baton
pass.
Yes,
yeah.
Just that reach and run.
So a penalty picked up, a track cut picked up by the Atlanta Jammer. Nuki on the power jam now for Helsinki. So Hermione Danger picking up the penalty. Nuki is through, lead jammer. So Helsinki will set up on the power jam. Ball or shot caller locked up at the rear of the pack.
Danger.
Nuki.
Danger with that star already in hand, so keep an eye on Mattitude adjustment with the pivot.
So less than 10 seconds in the penalty to Hermione Danger. She re-enters the pack behind Alu. So Nuki locked up at the front of the pack. Mattitude adjustment. Drifts back, picks up the jammer star. And Mattitude adjustment against 2 Helsinki blockers, but she is forced out at the very last second.
Well, and Alu started at the back of the pack to pull Danger back, and in 2 seconds was at the front knocking Maddie out.
Wow. Alu all over the place as a blocker there for Helsinki. And official review has been requested.
We're watching that replay. Rosie DeRiver at the back. Maddie with the star in hand on one skate, holds on, and then just that shove to the front.
That's a great camera angle. We can get that between turns 1 and 2. That's lots of action going on in that part of the track this weekend.
That is Coach Dr. Lady Danger. And it looks like Maddie is in the penalty box with star in hand for a forearms. We'll take a quick second to thank some of our amazing folks who we could not do this without. The WFTDA would like to thank Derby City Skates, Strong Athletic, the Texas Roller Girls, Derby Girl Designs, Chicks and Bulls, Rydell, Radar Wheels, Powerdyne, and Rollercom.
So we're getting a look at the penalties being flashed up on the screen here. Atlanta, 4 penalties to Mattitude adjustment. 2 skaters with 3, Baller Shot Caller and Blackjack.
And 3 of those for Maddie as the acting jammer.
Yeah.
Started as a pivot, but wearing that star.
And Helsinki, 2 skaters with 3 penalties each, Alu and Sarah Ekholm. Very busy blockers there for Helsinki. So you should be getting a verdict on the official review shortly.
Officials observed that the forearm was used to achieve the pass. Therefore, the forearm call stands. Atlanta does not retain their official review.
Okay.
So a forearm penalty assessed.
So Atlanta arguing that the forearm should not have been assessed to Maddie, and official is going to keep it.
So Atlanta losing their official review. And all of a sudden, we only have a minute five to play in the first period. Malou on the power jam for Helsinki. Malou on her toe stops, trying to find a seam to the inside. Malou, little apex skip. Gets caught up at the front of the pack by Coco. Gains lead.
Yeah, Erica Baduzzi with that first catch, and then Coco so fast to come up and join her. And heading to the penalty box for a direction.
So Malou is through, picking up 4 points for Helsinki. Penalty to Mattitude adjustment has ended. Maddie shrugs off that last hit to escape the pack. She'll put on the jammer star. Malou calls the jam, 4 points for Helsinki.
And after sitting in the penalty box, Maddie wanted those points so bad. She had really turned on the gas.
So we'll see if this is the last jam of the half.
We're seeing that hold in front. Blackjack and Erica Baduzzi sliding, positioning Blackjack and sliding all the way to the outside to keep it moving.
Yeah, so very mobile pack play there from Atlanta. Like I said, very close, very, very hard-fought game in the pack. The score doesn't seem to reflect it at this point. So we end the half. We go to the half. Helsinki 117, Atlanta 59. And we will take a little break, and we'll see you in about 15 minutes. Okay, we are back at the 2019 International WFTDA Playoffs in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. This is our first game of the day. We're at halftime with Helsinki leading by a score of 117-59. I'm Biff Mixalot. I'm joined by Sissy Splasek. Why don't we go over some of what happened in that first half, Sissy?
Yeah, so a quick recap. If it comes to numbers, we've really been seeing a leads in a penalty game, which obviously sounds very obvious, but when you read it all, it's important. Mm-hmm. So Helsinki picking up 13 lead jammers to Atlanta's 7.
Okay.
So they're already in a better position to call off jams, obviously, and to be in control of every minute that's happening out there. And then when it comes to jammer penalties, Helsinki so far with 1 and Atlanta with 7. Now, they're not all, I mean, they're technically jammer penalties, but at least four of those, are from pivots who have taken the star and then immediately incur a penalty.
So very costly penalties in that situation for Atlanta. And that disparity is reflected in our score, 117-59. And we're looking at the penalties that are flashed up on the screen now. Atlanta with 19 total to 11 for Helsinki. One skater with 4 penalties for Atlanta. That is number 21. That is Blackjack. Or 23, excuse me. Mattitude adjustment. She picked up some of those pivot turn jammer penalties for Atlanta. Atlanta with 2 skaters with 3. Helsinki, 2 skaters with 3 penalties. Number 51, Alou. And number 604, Sarah Ekholm. But only a total of 11 so far.
And Atlanta with 59 points so far this game, more than half of those from 2 power jams. So we had that jam with Troublemaker for 24, and then Aphrodite also having a pretty high-scoring jam in
pretty
her favor.
Pretty high-scoring. Scoring load has been pretty evenly divided there for Helsinki. Mia with 29 leading the way for them, followed by Kujala with 21 and Varbu Kanutula with 23. Action is underway. Aphrodite with a jammer star for Atlanta against Kujala. Aphrodite, the second leading scorer for Atlanta in the first half with 12 points. Leading scorer was Troublemaker with that aforementioned 24-point jam. And Kujala shrugs off contact, is through, lead jammer, first of the half for Helsinki.
Atlanta having a hard time figuring out Kujala, figuring how to stop her, because it seems like every time they adjust, there's an entire new set of skills that come into the very next pass.
Well, Atlanta is not the only one wondering that right now. So Aphrodite set off and picked up 4 points. Kujala picking up a back block somewhere in there. So Aphrodite collecting 4 points. Our score stands 117-63, 29 minutes left in the game. So nice start there for Atlanta. Power jam now for Gucci Mane. Gucci Mane, two Helsinki blockers to beat at the front. Gucci Mane spins out of the pack, gains lead jammer. Helsinki losing a blocker to the penalty box. Less than 10 seconds on the penalty to Kujala.
And it looks like Black Jacket picked up by four arms. Penalty, but is returning to the track.
Karja Leinen taking the seat in the penalty box for Helsinki. And Gucci Mane stretching the pack, picking up 4 points for Atlanta.
And I know we were talking about Alou's blocking for Helsinki in the first half, and then just there again, hands behind the back, just the calmest defensive blocking.
Gucci Mane collecting a back block penalty. So that's going to put Helsinki on the power jam with Kujala. Kujala going face to face with Queen Lucia Tifa, sent to the infield. Queen Lucia Tifa and Mattitude Adjustment anchoring the front of the pack for Atlanta.
You can see Baller Shot Caller. And one thing about her name is very accurate. She is out there calling the shots.
Alou doing some great work, trying to free Kujala from the pack. Kujala completes a 4-point scoring pass. Penalty to Gucci Mane is expired. Pack assembled at the entrance of turn three in front of the unicorn pool floaty. If you're not able to watch, you just have to picture it.
We're painting a picture here of unicorn pool floaties.
It's every bit as magnificent as it sounds. Kujala leaning into the pack. Jam time's out. Two more points for Atlanta. Four more for Helsinki. That is an 8-6 jam. 125-69 now in favor of Helsinki. 26-42 left in the game.
There we're seeing Gucci Mane hit the back. Yeah, absolutely there. And unfortunately picking up that back block, just square. It almost looked like it was going to be a little bit to the side, and then she turned at the last second to give her that back.
Yeah. So we have Troublemaker now jamming against Malou. Malou drawn back by Erica Baduzzi.
Queen with a real big hit on Malou.
So Troublemaker at the front of the pack, trying to break apart the Helsinki wall. Malou met with a tripod of Atlanta blockers at the rear. Troublemaker face to face with a Helsinki blocker. Both jammers grinding away at the front of the pack. Troublemaker gets recycled. Nobody moving very quickly. And a penalty to a Helsinki blocker, number 112, Fuchs.
Looks like Fuchs picked up a direction of gameplay penalty.
So 55 seconds in, Troublemaker picking up lead jammer for Atlanta. Pack reorganizes in the back straightaway.
Atlanta offense looking to really push in from both sides. And then you saw Erica Baduzzi and Queen push in and forward, and just Trouble was right behind, able to capitalize on that forward momentum.
Yeah, Erica Baduzzi just led a convoy out of the pack for Atlanta.
Really did.
So Troublemaker much more quickly this time into the pack for Atlanta. And she'll get drawn back into turns one and two. Malou, star in hand, completes her initial pass. Coco unable to keep her in the pack. Jam is called. One additional point for Atlanta. No points for Helsinki. A 5-0 jam in favor of Atlanta.
This game brought to you by Powerdyne Plates and Skate Products. For cutting-edge designs and cutting-edge performance, there is Powerdyne.
So Hermione Danger to jam now against Mia. And just a reminder, Helsinki skating in green, Atlanta in white. Jam is underway. Blockers massed around the pivot line. Mia sent to the infield by Ziploc.
It looked like Ziploc was joining her as well.
And Mia powers her way through. Lead jammer for Helsinki. Star has been passed for Atlanta. Two.
Baller shot caller.
Baller shot caller calling on some of her history as a jammer. Mia through the pack calls the jam. 4 points for Helsinki. No points for Atlanta. So that'll extend Helsinki's lead to 129-78, 23-30 left in the game. Aphrodite returning to the jammer line for Atlanta against Nuki.
We're seeing that loose three in the front. Baller joins, hits the inside. And then Helsinki takes that inside line.
Nuki spun to the inside. Aphrodite's made the most forward progress. Queen Luzia Tifa contending with Nuki at the rear of the pack.
And Fro really caught up in that, really from all directions.
Among the tall timber there, definitely the smallest in stature of the skaters in that pack.
Fuchs picking up the third direction penalty for her so far this game.
So Nina Urwas contending with Aphrodite at the rear of the pack. Aphrodite lowers the shoulder, tries to get to the inside. Helsinki regroups around Aphrodite.
I mean, and Fro's entire body was really coming up to Irwas' hip and locked that hip into her.
Trying to gain leverage there, but it's the pack is seized up in the back straightaway. Penalty to number 112 Fuchs has expired. And Helsinki losing their pivot. Number 85, Latakainen. Nuki still locked up at the rear of the pack. No lead jammer has been awarded yet.
This has been a long jam already.
Yeah, Blackjack trying to create some space. Blackjack picking up the jammer star, and Blackjack is out.
So, and then the communication there between Blackjack and Aphrodite, not even taking it off until the second she was ready to receive it.
Yep. And Blackjack spins around the outside. 4 points for Atlanta.
And all smiles.
And the crowd goes wild in Winston-Salem. Nuki still stuck at the rear of the pack. Blackjack on a second scoring pass. As the jam times out, one more point for Atlanta. A 5-0 jam for Atlanta.
That feels like it was the hardest fought point I've ever seen.
The most enthusiastically greeted points of the game.
There's Blackjack all the way to the outside.
Is that a 720 by Blackjack?
Yeah.
Holy smokes. October Revolution making heart signs as we talk about this.
Whew.
Wow. Five big points there for Atlanta. 83-129, 20-40 left in the game. Varpu Kanutila, the jammer for Helsinki against Gucci Mame of Atlanta. Pack seizes up at the apex of turns one and two. Gucci Mame, the most forward in the pack. Kanutila, one blocker to beat at the front, and Kanutila is out. A track cut picked up by Varpu Kanutila.
And that was Ziplock pulling track cut.
And now Atlanta with the power jam opportunity. Gucci Mame going chest to chest with Alou. Lowers the shoulder, gets lead for Atlanta.
Gucci wasn't just trying to move forward, she was trying to move sideways as well because they had her wedged in against that line.
Applying all the vectors of physics to her advantage. Gucci Mame spins to the inside of Alou. That's four more points for Atlanta.
After having a few jams in a row that were so, so tight and so strong, having just these last two open up just a little bit feels like everyone's kind of taking a breath.
Yeah, it's like the jammers have taken the crowbars out and pried everything loose. So Gucci Mame recycled all the way to the rear of the pack. Gucci's on a second scoring pass. Penalty to Kanutila has expired. She completes her initial. Gucci Mame calls the jam with the escort there from Erythrottle. Four more points to Atlanta. That's an 8-0 jam for Atlanta, and all of a sudden this deficit is under 40 points.
We're seeing Gucci there with that spin and just able to hold on.
And back to the chamber line for Atlanta's number 33, Troublemaker. And the crowd finally wakes up here in Winston-Salem. Malou, the jammer for Helsinki. Malou quickly to the inside, picks up lead. She's dragged back into the pack at the very last second.
Troublemaker still the lead scorer for Atlanta.
Malou being drawn back to the rear of the pack.
Malou taking a minute to catch, compose herself, maybe.
Latikainen retreats to provide some escort there through the pack. And Malou with lead, got recycled, is back out now. Forearm penalty assessed to number 31, Erica Beduzzi. And Malou through for 4 points.
That is Doozy's third penalty so far this game.
Malou into the pack. Malou out. Star has been passed for Atlanta to. That was
Blackjack. Blackjack. We saw in the first game Atlanta played, Blackjack had three passes in a row where she just could not get up there. She wants the fun.
Oh, yeah.
She wants to get in there and get those points and do those twirls.
Well, lots of experience in her past as a jammer. So we have Mia back to the jammer line against Hermione Danger. Blockers stuck between the jammer and pivot lines. Jam is underway. Mia into the middle of the pack. Hermione Danger to the inside. She is through. Lead jammer for Atlanta. Mia in hot pursuit. Jammer shifting up through the gears into turns one and two. Jammer defense by Hermione Danger. Hermione Danger around the outside. That's four for Atlanta. And a penalty collected by Mia. A track cut. Atlanta's on the power jam. And perhaps the crowd in Winston-Salem sensing a momentum shift here. Hermione Danger drawn back into the back straightaway.
Hermione looking to be a little cautious, starting to put a foot in there.
So Hermione Danger from a standing start gets through, pops around the outside. That's four more points for Atlanta. 8-0 in the jam. Pack regrouping in the back straightaway. Hermione Danger, a third scoring pass. Whistles in the pack.
Yeah, Maddie and Baller both working to open that up and now rejoining. You can see Erica Beduzzi there.
And an illegal contact by Alou. The second Helsinki blocker to head to the penalty box. Sala Karjalainen joining her there.
Looks like that was a direction of gameplay.
And Hermione Danger, a third scoring pass. That's 12 points total on the jam for Atlanta so far. Their biggest jam of the half. Hermione Danger around the outside, around Eckholm. That is for a fourth scoring pass. 16 on the jam. Atlanta's scoring triple digits now. Pack reassembling in the backstretch. Mia, her penalty is over, drawing Hermione Danger back. Jam ends. Three more points for Atlanta. So a 19-point jam for Atlanta. It is now 140 to 110 in favor of Helsinki.
And Danger saw that jammer coming for her and just slid a little. Just let her take a little of her own momentum out to the outside.
So an official review has been requested, it appears. Requested by Helsinki.
And we've had a bit of a penalty shift so far. I know we were talking a little bit more about that in the first half. As always, they've now shifted. We have had 10 so far for Helsinki, just this half alone, and only four for Atlanta.
Okay, so that makes the total 23-21. So I think it's a little more at parity now. And that seems reflected in the shift in momentum taking place on the track.
The S1 Life Revisor helmet. Get next level protection with S1 helmets. S1helmets.com.
So the coaches presenting their case for the official review. See how this plays out.
A lot of understanding nods going around.
Yes. Showing that they're listening. That's good.
Helsinki's official review for the second period. They are requesting an overturn of the forearm penalty to the green jammer.
Okay, then.
All right.
So we will wait to see how that one plays out. I mean, that was referees retreating to their corner.
Yeah, it was a very big jam for Atlanta, so it would be beneficial to have it overturned. You see jammer stats there. We have lead scores for Helsinki. Really, again, still very even.
Yeah, very balanced scoring attack.
They've on the got Helsinki side.
Five jammers in double-digit scoring.
And then Atlanta, troublemakers still ahead with 33. We have 18 now for Gucci Mame. Aphrodite with 16. Blackjack with 11. And Hermione Danger with 8.
And neither team is reluctant to give multiple skaters jamming opportunities. Helsinki has used 6 people in the jammer role. Atlanta has had 7. Now, some of those have been star passes, but you have 7 people on that roster that have done some jamming.
Yeah, 3 of those. Baller Shot Collar, Matitude Adjustment, and Blackjack. All primarily pivots, but also have all, of course, trained as jammers and been lead jammers different seasons in their own right.
So we should be getting a verdict here shortly. Captains have been summoned. And our alternate ref is wandering over to the dais right now.
If you want to follow along with the live game updates and matchups, go to stats@wftda.com. You can forecast the game results, the rest of the game results, keep up with who's playing when, and see how the playoffs affect live rankings. All at stats.wftda.com.
That's been a great resource all weekend. I've called upon it many times just to get some history on some of these teams. So verdicts are being delivered as we speak. So the verdict is coming now on the official review.
All right, looks like we're having a little bit of mic trouble, so we will deliver what we have been told, which is that Helsinki asked for the forearms penalty to be removed, but it was a cut track penalty that was issued.
Okay, so Aphrodite, the jammer for Atlanta, she is lead. Kujala wearing the jammer star for Helsinki. She has just now completed her initial pass. So Aphrodite into the pack in a scoring run. Pack accelerating rapidly around the track. Aphrodite takes a tumble to the outside, has to reset.
I feel like that was the fastest we have seen these blockers as a whole backs move so far this game. It's
and now the blocker,
tight defense.
Yeah, the blockers have reasserted themselves here at the moment, bringing everything to a grinding halt at the entrance of turn 3. Both jammers in the pack on a scoring pass. Kujala spinning out of the pack first. That's 4 points to Helsinki. And penalty assessed to number 112, Fuchs. Aphrodite calls the jam. But she was able to collect 4 points. So a 4-4 jam. Margin remains at 30 points.
See the replay there? That was when the pack was moving so fast. Air throttle being pushed by Aphrodite to make that hole for her and just the pile up on the outside.
Air throttle moving there at full throttle. So, back to the general line for Helsinki's number 22, Malou, jamming against number 10, 17, Gucci Mame. Gucci Mame with the most forward progress. Atlanta with a 4-on-2 pack advantage as the jam starts, and Gucci Mame is out and lead jammer for Atlanta.
Yeah, you're seeing Atlanta with that split offense that they have been practicing. So they started at the top of the pack, wrapped around, two on each side, compress in, and give Gucci the option of in or out.
Gucci Mame with the apex jump, picking up 4 points. Malou with the apex skip of her own, collecting 4 points for Helsinki. A track cut, unfortunately, has been assessed to Gucci Mame. So Helsinki is going to go on the power jam. Malou with the jammer star. Malou is not the lead jammer, so this jam is going to go 2 full minutes. Malou bouncing around in the pack. Outside, inside, has to recycle.
And looks like we had a forearms penalty there for Sala Karjalan.
Baller shot caller, nice block there to keep Malou in the pack. Penalty to Gucci Mame has expired. So 44 seconds left in the jam. Both jammers locked up in the pack, both on scoring passes. Gucci Mame, I believe, probably had some points in hand before the penalty was assessed.
I think so. She was in about the middle of the pack.
Yep. So Malou recycles to the rear of the pack. Gucci Mame going face to face at the front of the pack with Karjalainen. And Mayurine, excuse me. Gucci Mame shrunk out by Fuchs.
Ziploc was playing the role of that safety blocker there, supporting the brace and then also being able to dart in or out as needed.
Whistles in the pack. And the jam will time out. 4 more points for Gucci Mame. 4 more points for Malou. So an 8-8 jam. The gap remains 30 points. Less than 11 minutes remaining in the game.
So we might see that track cut here from Gucci. While we were all watching this amazing apex jump, we were
perfectly executed apex jump there by Malou. Nuki back to the jammer line against number 394, Hermione Danger. Hermione Danger drawn back behind number 28, Nina Irwis. And Hermione Danger casts the spell. Lead jammer for Atlanta.
Danger with that beautiful offense from Erica Baduzzi.
And Hermione Danger slithering through the inside. 4 more points for Atlanta. Quick 4 there for Atlanta. And Hermione Danger spun to the outside by Nuki playing jammer defense. Second scoring pass for Hermione Danger.
And Helsinki sort of stuck behind the Atlanta wall. It was kind of a tricky position there. It was like they were trying to move up, but they were actually stuck behind as well.
Yeah, it seemed like everything was mixed up. And Nuki just launched herself into, you know, maybe a role of playing jammer defense, you know, with Hermione Danger so quickly able to establish lead. Now the pack's locked down.
You see Blackjack moving back and forth to support and to bridge, or to possibly be in a position to take the star.
Yeah. Nuki leaning into the pack. And a track cut penalty assessed to Hermione Danger. So Nuki, the jammer of record for Helsinki, she has yet to complete an initial pass. Nuki stashing the star.
Blackjack with that takeout.
So Atlanta defending the power jam. Erica Baduzzi at the rear of the pack, holding up Nuki. The jam will time out. 3 points to Hermione Danger before she went to the penalty box. So a 7-0 jam for Atlanta, and all of a sudden it's a 23-point game. 8:25 left.
You're seeing that replay there of Hermione Danger hit out, steps back on.
Oh.
Yeah, hands up. She had already turned and started running.
Ruotsalainen with the block to draw the cut. Kujala will be jamming for Helsinki. They will start on the power jam. And Kujala gets recycled. Kujala hopping on the toe stops, gets out. Lead jammer for Helsinki. Helsinki rushing to the front of the pack. Jammer star has been passed to number 143, Baller shot caller for Atlanta.
And it looks like Baller almost had a clear shot around the outside. It's going to be a very, very fast pass, but Helsinki with that tap out.
Baller looked like she was approaching that a bit cautiously. Was trying to make sure she avoided the track card of the illegal re-entry penalty. But Kujala at the rear of the pack on a scoring pass. And Kujala with the back block. Oh, a high block. And that's going to be a power jam now for Atlanta. Unfortunately, Baller shot caller collects a track cut penalty. The power jam giveth, the power jam taketh away.
This is maybe the most jammer penalties I have seen in a game in quite a long time.
Yeah, a lot happening there. So the penalty to Kujala is expired. Less than 10 seconds on the penalty to Baller shot caller.
With just seven, just this half alone.
So this jam will go 2 full minutes, where it's 6:30 left in the game. Neither jammer with lead status.
Looks like Ziploc heading to the penalty box for Atlanta.
Kujala picking up 4 hard-earned points for Helsinki. Baller shot caller drawn to the rear by Alou. Kujala getting an escort from Ekholm as the jam times out. 3 more points for Helsinki. That'll give them a little bit of breathing space with Thunder 6 minutes left. They lead by 159 to 129.
It's a close game.
It is. It's turning into a close game.
Like, I know we had a spread of about 60 there for a little bit, but it's just
and
been tightening
Atlanta
up.
Atlanta seized momentum. Has tightened some things up. They got the crowd behind them, I think.
Oh, there was that beautiful pass from Maddie. I'm sorry, excuse me, to Baller shot caller, and then just the step out.
Okay, we've got Aphrodite jamming against Mia. Aphrodite is lead jammer. Mia, 20 feet behind in hot pursuit. Helsinki forms up at wall at the rear of the pack. Aphrodite approaching on a scoring pass. Mia through around the outside, picks up a track cut penalty. Power jam to Atlanta. So Aphrodite set at the rear of the pack, finds a seam to the inside and through. That's 4 points for Atlanta.
Blackjack heading as the pivot to the penalty box for Atlanta.
So pack set up in turn one. Atlanta swings into offense. Aphrodite trying to get through at speed.
Yeah, this pack is moving fast. Well, as soon as they say that, of course, the Helsinki locks in.
That's a form of the announcer's curse. We invoke that on pack speed.
Always.
We have that sort of power. But Aphrodite on a second scoring pass. Getting an assist from Erica Baduzzi. Aphrodite drawn back. Mia, penalty has expired. Mia hops back up. Completes a 4-point scoring pass. Aphrodite calls the jam.
And Ziploc, right before that, as hard as she could to push that Helsinki pack forward to separate those packs, and then you saw Blackjack immediately join to actually open the hole.
Yeah. Again, great teamwork by the Atlanta pack there. So a 6-4 jam in favor, 6-4 jam in favor of Atlanta. Score stands 163 to 135.
Yeah, so we're going to see that.
Okay. So 3:46 remaining. Time not on Atlanta's side here, but Gucci Mame, the jammer, against Malou. Gucci Mame with some help from Erythrottle through and lead jammer for Atlanta. Power jam. Penalty picked up by Malou. So Gucci Mame with speed into the pack.
Looks like Malou had picked up a forearms penalty.
So nice block there by Ziplock in front of the pack, trying to get Gucci Mame free. Ekholm, Yumina Logora locking down at the front for Helsinki. And Ekholm picking up an out-of-play block penalty. Atlanta, 4-on-2 pack advantage. Penalty to Malou has expired. Gucci Mame spins into the pack. One blocker to beat at the front.
We may see a, we may see a star pass right here at the back. And we did.
So pass has been handed off to Mayurine of Helsinki. Gucci Mame, four more points.
Anytime you see the jammer and the pivot released at the same time, keep an eye on that.
So Mayurine into the pack and a scoring pass for Helsinki. Gucci Mame through. Four more points for Atlanta. 12-0 jam for Atlanta. The deficit is under 20 points. Pack gathered at the apex of turns one and two. Gucci Mame tries the apex jump, does not land it, is drawn back into the front straight.
Ziplock heading to the penalty box for Atlanta with a forearms penalty and joined by Erythrotto.
So Mayurine through for 4 points for Helsinki. The jam times out. Two more points to Atlanta. A 14-4 jam. 167-149.
We're seeing the replay there of that offensive block from Ziplock. Cuts in front, wraps around, and Gucci's able to follow right through. And then Helsinki, all day long, they've been just closing that door.
Yeah, they're able to just somehow they take that, they turn the energy to where they can just kind of shut the door on the jammer as they come through. You saw it there from Yamina Lugora and Sarah Ekholm. So this is an 18-point game. Timeout has been called by Atlanta. Less than 2 minutes remaining.
Yeah, I feel like that was, I mean, we keep seeing from Helsinki, I haven't talked about it a ton, but these their pair work, they're being separated from each other and coming together to lock, close those elevator doors right on the jammer every time.
And it's, and like I said, at this stage of the game, that's going to come in very, very handy.
Atlanta has closed the gap by 40 points so far this half. And it's on a 90-point scoring run this half against Helsinki's 50. Now we're seeing that Aris rattle to the outside and Gucci around the end.
So Atlanta gets a minute to recharge their batteries. They send number 23, Matitude Adjustment to the jammer line. Mia, the jammer for Helsinki.
Atlanta starting with two blockers in the box.
And those blockers are gathered at the pivot line. Matitude Adjustment playing some jammer defense there on Mia. Is it going to pay off?
And you saw Maddie just feed Mia to Blackjack and Baller just a little bit.
Fuchs trying to create some space at the rear of the pack for Mia. And Mia finds room around the perimeter. Lead jammer for Helsinki. Matitude Adjustment hot on her heels. Matitude Adjustment with the jammer defense. Both jammers into the pack. Mia out with 4 points.
We saw Mia trying to tell her pack, just calm down, calm down. Take it slow.
So Mia approaching the pack somewhat cautiously. Matitude Adjustment in the front of the pack, contending with a tripod of Helsinki blockers. Erythrotto lowers the shoulder, clears a path. Wasn't quite able to get Matitude Adjustment out. Mia completes another scoring pass. That is 8 total in the jam for Helsinki.
It's like keep your eye on Blackjack. Maddie has that star in her hand.
Blackjack receives the jammer star.
And this clock is counting down.
So Atlanta with 3 points now. Blackjack will go on a second scoring pass. Less than 20 seconds in the period. Less than 29 seconds left in the jam.
And in the game.
Oh. So Blackjack through 3 points. There was a no pass, no penalty in the pack. Mia picking up 4. And Mia will call the jam. And as the period clock ends, congratulations. So our unofficial final, Helsinki 179, Atlanta 155. So Atlanta's second half rally falls just a bit short.
Oh, I think Zip's skate broke again at the end of that. She's on one skate.
Oh.
And getting a little help from a friend.
I think that skate knew when the clock was expiring. That's when it broke.
Until the very end.
As inanimate objects sometimes tend to do.
Replay there of Blackjack getting through and then right behind. And then congratulating.
The jammer love.
Yeah.
Before the whistle blows. So we're getting set to for the teams to take their handshake laps. Helsinki starting that process now. And so just a really hard-fought, well-played game by both teams. A little penalty heavy at times, but you know, Atlanta, you know, they spotted a big lead at half, but they did a good job to rally to make the game as close as it ended up being at the end.
Yeah, I mean, a little penalty heavy, but also even, pretty much even.
Right.
Helsinki with 31 total, Atlanta with 30 total. Atlanta with a few more of those being jammer penalties than blocker penalties, but also with an unbelievable comeback in that second half.
Yeah, just felt a little short at the end. But you could sense they had the momentum going, and if this bout had gone on maybe another couple of minutes, they could have closed the gap.
Yeah, well, and my lovely producer, October Rev, doing math for me. Twitter has apparently said that announcers always say they're not good at math. I'm sorry, I am not good at math, but Rev is very good at it. So it actually looks like jammer penalties were pretty even. Ended up pretty even. So Helsinki was 7, Atlanta
Helsinki
was 10.
Helsinki picked up a few there in the latter stages. So that helped Atlanta close the gap a bit. And anyway, so do we have a post-game interview on this?
Yes, we absolutely will. We'll give them a little bit of time.
Yeah, give them some time to set up and kick out a skater. So anyway, that was a consolation game. Stick around. We've got Paris taking on Bear City, the Battle of the EU here in Winston-Salem. And then we have the bronze medal game at 3 o'clock and the gold medal game at 5:30. This is just the beginning of a full day of derby here in Winston-Salem.
Full day of derby and, of course, those games not just for all the glory and the medals, but also for seeds and shots at championships.
That's right. Somebody gets to punch their ticket to Montreal. Texas and Angel City have already done so. We will see who does that between Rainy City and Dos por Cuatro in the bronze medal game.
Yeah, it's going to be really exciting. All right, it looks like we're going to throw down to our friend Death Nella with Helsinki.
All right.
Thank you. I am joined by Mia. Congratulations. Thank you. A strong finish on this tournament. Obviously not exactly how you wanted things to end, but how do you feel about your performance in this tournament? It has been an incredible year for Helsinki.
Yeah, I'm kind of happy to our team. We got our things back together after yesterday's loss. But maybe next year then, I hope so.
I was just going to say, what is next for Helsinki? Because it has been a year of international travel for your team as well.
Yes. Next up, we probably will have some home game, if I remember correctly. And then we will just keep practicing and waiting for the next year.
No rest for Helsinki. Now, you beat a team from Lille, France in the first round. You were defeated by a team from Manchester, UK. And then in the next game, we're going to see Paris and Bear City. So it's been a year for Euro Derby. And really, it's been a number of years, an upward trajectory. How are you feeling about the performance of Euro Derby at this tournament?
I'm so proud of all the European teams doing it. Because like I have been playing for like 8 years now, so I have really seen how the Euro Derby has grown. So I'm so happy to have like so many European teams today here with us.
Well, I know there are Helsinki fans around the world, but back home it's 7 hours ahead of here right now. So thank you for watching. If you're watching from Helsinki, do you have a message for your supporters and for those who have just been introduced to Helsinki at this tournament?
Well, thank you for watching and cheering for us. It means a lot.
Well, congratulations, Mia. Go celebrate with your team. Have a great rest of your time here in Winston-Salem.
Thank you.
And now coming up, we have the matchup between Paris and Bear City. That's happening at 1 p.m. Eastern. followed by the bronze match. That's between Dos Por Cuatro, and it's going to come to me in just a moment. I'm going to remember the other team now. Of course, my notes are on the ground. Both teams in the bronze medal matchup have never been to playoffs, so stick around for that. That's coming up. And then the gold medal game is between Texas Roller Girls and Angel City. So we'll be back with more great WFTDA playoff action live from Winston-Salem in just a moment.